In this video, we're going to take a look at how to evaluate a limit graphically, and we're also going to look at a lot of common problems that show up when we try to evaluate these limits graphically. So we'll start off with a pretty easy example like this. Here's f of x, this is the blue line here, and I want to know what's the limit, or in other words, what does the function approach as the x's get closer to 3? And I went ahead and wrote this definition down because it's going to be important in a minute. A limit determines what value a function approaches as x approaches some number. So as the x's get closer to 3, I can draw some yellow arrows here, and it seems that the function is approaching 4, right? And so that would be the correct answer. Right now, with all this limit discussion, somebody might very well say, well Devin, why are you talking about limits and have this crazy notation? Being that f of 3 was 4, why could we not just take 3 and plug it in the function and get 4? Well, so you have to differentiate what the function value is versus what the limit is. Because if there's ever a discrepancy, the limit could be different than a function value. And I just want to kind of flesh that out a little bit here. So let me start changing some things, and we'll see if this answer of 4 changes or doesn't change. So right now this dot is filled in at 4, but what if I remove it? What if I take that dot away and I redefine the y value at 3 to be 6, let's say, right? And then I ask this question again. What's the limit as x goes to 3 for this function? Well, let's read the definition again. A limit determines what value the function approaches as the x's get closer to 3. So do you think the answer would be 4, or do you think the answer would be 6? Well, hopefully you said 4, because the limit is still 4. Because if you see my yellow arrows, they're still pointing like big flashing yellow lights towards 4. And so this would still be the limit. Now, if somebody also said, what is f of 3? Well, then notice there's no limit expressed here. This is just asking, what's the y value at 3? How is the function defined at 3? And this answer would be 6, okay? But that's different than what the limit is. So just be aware, if there's a discrepancy, the limit might not necessarily be the same as the function value. It's all about where the function is headed. All right, let me change a couple of other things. All right, so we're going to do lots of different examples here in this one example. All right, so what if I erase maybe the right-hand side right here, okay? And then let's say I do a close dot right here, and then I change it to be like this. So here's f of x, and then I ask the question again, what's the limit as x gets closer to 3? Now, there's all sorts of common answers I see all the time, and one of them's correct and the rest are wrong. Sometimes I'll hear the limit might be 6, because you see how this is a closed dot and this is an open dot, so maybe for whatever reason that has a stronger influence on the limit being 6 than 4 maybe. I've heard, it might sound silly to some of you, but I've heard an answer of 5, because maybe, you know, I don't know, maybe split the difference between 6 and 4 and the limit or where the function's headed is kind of halfway between those two. I've heard 6 and 4, maybe they're both limits perhaps, and I've also heard maybe the limit does not exist. Now, one of these four options is correct. Let me start knocking them out one by one. All right, the silliest is probably this 5, right? That's not the right answer. A limit determines what value a function approaches. Nothing goes to 5. 5 is big empty space right here, so don't think that if it's kind of halfway between, you can like average the values out. That's certainly not true, right? Next one to go is 6. The answer is not 6. One thing that we want to stress about limits is limits do not care what happens at 3. And like in this example, in general, we would say x equals c. We don't care what happens here. We care what happens as the function approaches, or the x values approach some number. So don't think just because this is a closed dot versus an open dot, it's any more likely to be 6 than 4. It could have been an open dot and an open dot, or open dot and the point defined at 8. I mean, it doesn't matter. What happens at 3 in this little box right here is completely irrelevant in regards to the limit. Now, probably the most understandable incorrect answer would be an answer of 6 and 4, because in some sense, the function is approaching 4, right, from the left-hand side, and approaching 6 from the right-hand side. But if you take a closer look at the definition, you see this is actually not possible either, because a limit determines what value. Notice how that's singular, this one answer, not what values, but what value a function approaches as x approaches some number from both sides. Now, what we wind up seeing based off of all this is there's not one number that the function approaches. If you say the answer is 4, I could counter argue that, well, the right side doesn't go to 4, it goes to 6. And so you say, well, if the answer is maybe the limit 6, I could say, well, the left side goes to 4 and not 6. There's no definitive value that this function approaches. So for this limit, we would say this one does not exist. So just be aware of that. Probably the last thing I can say that would clarify this is that the only way a limit can exist is if the two different one-sided limits agree with one another. So if the limit from the left does not match the limit from the right-hand side, the limit will never exist. The one-sided limits from the left and the right have to be going to the same place. Now, whether it's defined at that middle point, 3 or whatever your x value is completely unimportant. It doesn't matter at all in regards to whether the limit exists or not.